Satin Hove is one of the city's most expensive options on the market. King's House, a Grade 2 listed building, belongs to Brighton and Hove City Council, who are looking for buyers. In July 2014, the building was valued at £10 million, but due to rising market prices, the current asking price has doubled to £20 million. Despite this hefty price tag, there were of course interested bidders. A consortium of 9 unnamed property developers had reportedly bid in excess of £20 million for the prominent seafront office block. The group planned to turn the building into flats, but those plans have now been halted, and councillor Robert Nemeth spoke about the problems facing the project and where the mistakes were made along the process.
So the problem with King's House, which is what I highlighted at full council last week, was the falling through of the sale by the administration, which has been ongoing for at least a year. So I've said it's a wasted year of work. It's put back £360,000 of council tax that might otherwise have been collected had a residential scheme come forward. And not only that, a deposit wasn't taken, and maybe you'd expect 10%, 5%, but that's about £1 million wasted. So overall, well over £1 million wasted by the council when we need this sort of cash for valuable services around the city.
The sale of the property was always going to be a tricky negotiation, but councillor Nemeth says this could have been better managed.
It was always going to be a tricky site, but this could have been avoided if the council had packaged the deal properly. So you've got a giant queue of people wishing to buy the building. It's one of the top pieces of real estate in the city, certainly in Hove. And what we saw was a developer saying they'd wish to buy it. Who wouldn't want to buy it? It's an amazing building. But then finding that they have a whole host of different questions on height, listing status, materials, everything about what might be acceptable for the site. And these are all things that could have been cleared up before they promised to buy it.
With the sale falling through roughly 2 weeks ago, Councillor Nemeth brought this to the attention at full council and made further suggestions as to how these procedures should follow.
Well, my role at full council was to highlight the failings of the administration, and I put forward a motion to the exact effect of what you've just suggested, which is essentially calling on the administration councillors to make a full statement publicly to say what went wrong, to fully brief councillors on the secret elements of the deal, and to essentially package the project in a certain way that means that whoever snaps it up knows exactly what they're buying and that they are going to be paying a deposit, a hefty deposit, so that if they pull out, it's not the people of Brighton and Hove who are left out of pocket.
With housing an already serious situation in Brighton, Councillor Nemeth sees King's House as a route out of that problem.
The case has been made that there's not strong demand for office space in such a location in Hove. So the obvious use now is residential. And I'm more than happy with that. It'd be a wonderful place to live.